Did you ever wonder, what is it about the helmet that makes it so protected? Is it just about the outer part that you see in your helmet, or is it the inner pads that keep you protected? Well, today I'm going to show you exactly how your helmets keep you safe. But before we continue, check out our website to get the best deals and offers on your helmet. We will match any price guaranteed. Please don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel and leave a like and a comment. Today, I will be diving into the full anatomy of a helmet. First up, let's talk about the shell. This is the protective outermost layer of the helmet that's visible to the outside world. And it's made from strong materials such as fiberglass, polycarbonate or carbon fiber. And the outer shell is designed to distribute and absorb impact forces during a crash. It's your first line of defense. The EPS, or expanded polystyrene, is the innermost layer of the helmet that you can see here. And it acts as a shock absorber. This foam material is engineered to compress and absorb the energy generated during an impact. The EPS shell is crucial in cushioning your head and reducing the severity of potential injuries. The inner liner refers to the interior padding and components that contribute to an overall comfort, fit and functionality of the helmet. It includes various elements such as the cheek pads that you can see right here, the crown pad deep inside the helmet, and a neck roll that supports your neck to make those longer rides comfortable, and a chin curtain right here. Alright, I'm going to take the helmet apart and show you what each component looks like outside of the helmet. This is the crown pad and it provides cushioning and support to the rider's head. Cheek pads are located on the sides of the helmet and provide a snug fit around the rider's cheeks. They help in securing the helmet in place and in providing comfort. And up next, we have the neck roll. As you can see, it's missing from the bottom of the helmet, and this is made, like I mentioned before, to support your neck and make the helmet a little bit more comfortable. And the final thing I'm going to discuss is this forehead padding, which adds a little extra comfort and makes it easier to achieve a snug fit around your head. So I've quickly grabbed a different helmet to show you the chin curtain, because not all helmets really like it when you remove the chin curtain. Like the name would suggest, it's located at the chin area and it does provide an extra bit of cushioning, but it also keeps out the wind, dust and debris from coming inside your helmet, creating a bit more comfort and also a quieter riding experience. Now the chin curtain is a chin piece of the helmet which safeguards the lower portion of your face, which is both your chin and your jaw, and it adds an extra layer of protection and helps maintain the helmet's structural integrity. Safety is our top priority. For the modular helmet enthusiasts out there, the flip-up mechanism is a game changer, and with this feature you can easily lift the entire front section of the helmet, including the chin bar, transforming your full face helmet into an open face helmet, enjoying the flexibility of exposing your face without the need to fully remove your helmet. We've covered the protection of the entire head and you've seen every part of the helmet, and you might be wondering, wouldn't it be too much pressure and strain on my neck? Well, you don't have to worry about that at all. Now this component at the bottom that I showed you here, the neck roll, and this provides additional cushioning, support and comfort, enhancing the overall fit of the helmet. This neck roll reduces wind noise and turbulence while maintaining a secure and comfortable fit for long riding periods. Now comes one of the critical safety features in a helmet, the emergency quick release. And these are commonly used on full face helmets, which allows for rapid removal of the helmet in case of an emergency or accident. It typically involves a mechanism that enables easy quick release of the chin strap, facilitating the helmet's removal by emergency personnel. To add a final detail, this is the chin strap, which fastens securely under the rider's chin. It ensures that your helmet is snug, comfortable, providing stability and preventing the helmet from coming off during a crash or high-speed riding. The chin strap is an essential component in the helmet's retention system, enhancing safety on the road. Guess it's not all about the outer shell, right? Let's keep going. Before we move on, just want to remind you to check out our website and our social media platforms. You can find their link in the description below. And of course, don't forget to subscribe. The visor, also known as the face shield, is generally found as a transparent visor that covers the front of the helmet. It shields your face from wind, debris, insects and any other hazards you might encounter on the road. With different positions available, you can adjust the visor to allow for varying levels of airflow, but this is only the outer visor. Some helmets also come fitted with an inner visor called a drop-down visor. And this additional shield, often tinted, protects your eyes from bright sunlight with an easy-to-use mechanism that you can lower or raise whenever you want to, eliminating the need for separate sunglasses. But this is not all about the visors. Fogging is also an issue, but for that we have these incredible pinlock lenses. And this anti-fog insert attaches to the inside of the helmet's visor, creating a double pane system with a layer of air in between. This innovative design reduces moisture buildup and ensures a clear view of the road, even in humid or cold conditions. You'll see this included in the box with the better helmets. So many visors on one helmet, but how do manufacturers make it easy to move, you ask? Well, we have to give credit to the advanced visor mechanisms available these days, which make it a breeze. This system ensures smooth and effortless operation, allowing you to easily adapt to changing riding conditions and no more struggling with your visor. This convenience is now at your fingertips.
It must be playing in your mind. Such a solid helmet, but where is the breathing space?
Helmets have been critically designed to provide you with proper air ventilation when you're out on the road. Proper airflow is essential to keep you cool and comfortable. Starting with the top vent, it's strategically positioned at the helmet's upper part to allow fresh air to enter and flow through the helmet. This helps regulate temperature and prevent excessive heat buildup. Moving down to the chin vent, this vent is typically located at the front of the helmet near the chin area. It enables air to enter and flow directly onto your face, providing a refreshing breeze during your ride. In some specific cases, you may also find a brow vent, positioned on the upper part of the helmet's front. The brow vent directs airflow across your forehead, reducing sweat and fogging, and especially during hot weather. To ensure proper ventilation, helmets also include exhaust or air outlets, and these outlets are strategically placed to allow hot and still air to exit the helmet, containing a continuous flow of fresh air. Another feature that contributes to your riding comfort is the wind deflector or breath guard, and these components are often included in helmets to redirect airflow and reduce wind noise. They can enhance overall riding experience by minimizing wind turbulence and providing a quieter ride. But it doesn't stop there. The EPS shell, the inner layer of the helmet, also incorporates ventilation channels. And these channels are designed to guide the airflow from the vents and distribute it effectively throughout the helmet. They help regulate temperature, reduce heat buildup, and keep you cool on those long rides. Now obviously, the ventilation inside the EPS shell might look a little different per helmet, but to give you an idea, in our helmet it looks like this. It's these tiny little holes inside the EPS that helps distribute the air throughout the helmet. The statement of today's technology keeps you connected anywhere and everywhere is absolutely true. And in terms of your riding experience, I can say that this is something most manufacturers have started incorporating as just part of the helmet rather than an add-on feature. We are talking about helmet communication systems. Helmets now come in preparation for a communication system. This means that they have a dedicated pocket and channels to accommodate communication devices, such as Bluetooth systems. In some cases, you may even find helmets with integrated speakers. These speakers are strategically placed within the helmet, allowing you to listen to music, receive GPS instructions, or communicate with fellow riders without the need of external attachments. Not only this, but some helmets also have integrated microphones, meaning that you can now take phone calls or use voice commands seamlessly while on the go. And there you have it. That wraps up our in-depth exploration of the various components of a motorcycle helmet. Remember, each part plays a crucial role in providing protection, comfort, and an enjoyable riding experience. But before you go, don't forget to hit that like, subscribe, and share button and leave your thoughts in the comments. We'd like to hear what you guys think. Maybe there's a topic that you guys would like us to discuss in our next video. Leave a comment down below, stay safe, and until next time.